Turn up your sound system to the sound of Carlos Santana in the GMB. Getaway Blues from the refugee camp.
Hey guys, Lazy Man here. Hey, if you guys remember a couple videos ago, we had made these custom grommets for the motherboard tray. And if you haven't seen that video yet, just go back and look for how to make custom grommets for your motherboard tray. But anyway, originally I wanted to use, you know, a thin rubber, and I just wasn't sure how I was going to attach that to the motherboard tray. You know, I thought about maybe using an epoxy, you know, even super gluing it, double-sided tape, but I wasn't, you know, too confident that that would hold the rubber on very well, especially if you're, you know, putting your cables in and out. So anyway, if you guys remember, you know, I went to the craft store and I came up with this this high-dense foam here. You know, this was a 16th inch high-dense foam with a adhesive backing. So I started thinking that this might work, and then, you know, in the store it looked really black. So I got this home, and as you guys remember, we went ahead and made these grommets, and if you take a look at that, they came out pretty nice. And I was actually pretty happy with the way they turned out. The only thing that bothered me when I was done was that they, you know, they were a shade of black. You know, they didn't match the deep black that the motherboard tray is. So anyway, you know, I started thinking that, you know, I've got to find a way to make these out of rubber. And so I started brainstorming with, you know, a couple guys on YouTube. And, you know, I'd been going to McMaster Car, and I was looking up, you know, different types of rubber. And I'll tell you, I don't know if you guys have ever been to McMaster Car, but, man, they carry everything. They carry anything and everything you need. But I'll tell you, you got to know what you're looking for, because you have all kinds of different options. I mean, just for the rubber, I mean, there must have been 100 different options, you know, heat temperature and flexibility and this and that. I mean, so many options that I was getting so frustrated. You know, I was either going to give up or just buy anything and see how it turned out. Well, anyway, one of the YouTubers sent me a link to Amazon, and, you know, nice and simple, you know, for like $8, you can pick up a sheet of rubber. So anyway, that's what I went ahead and did. So if you hold on a minute, I'll show you what we have. All right, guys, here's the rubber I went ahead and picked up. It's a 16th inch sheet of rubber. It's 1 foot wide by 2 foot long. And when they ship this, you know, it comes rolled up in a package, and they put like talcum powder in it. I guess that's to keep it from, you know, if it got too hot during shipping, that it doesn't stick to each other or possibly melt. But anyway, I went ahead and took some soap and water, and I washed it off. And even doing that, you guys can see here, you know, it's got different shades of black. You know, it's awfully blotchy. And, you know, that wasn't going to work for me. So I was trying to think, well, how am I going to get this to be all one shade? So I went into my garage, and, you know, I pulled out the Armor All right here, and I tried that. And it kind of made, you know, it actually did the job, but it made it kind of, you know, kind of oily and kind of left fingerprints on it. I tried this here, did the kind of the same thing. So I went back to the automotive store, and, you know, I talked to a couple guys there, and they told me that this Trim Shine is the stuff that I'd like to, that I should use for this rubber. So anyway, I picked up a, you know, a can of that, and let me show you how that turned out. All right, guys, after applying about 2 or 3 coats of the Trim Shine, you know, you can see here that we have one consistent color of black. We got rid of all the blotches. You know, that looks pretty good. You know, it seems a little glossy, but I think as, you know, we cut out these little grommets, I don't think that glossiness is going to be a problem. But anyway, let me show you how this is going to look. Anyway, that's what we have now for the grommets, and you can see that we have a totally different shade of black. So anyway, if I put this up to it, that's what we'll end up with. So as you can see, the color range is a lot closer. And I think with this rubber, what it's going to allow me to do is, if you can see here on these foam grommets, you know, I was only able to slot them straight across, which works, but it makes it a very tight opening. with the rubber here, what I'm going to do is, of course, we're going to, for this top piece, we're going to use the rubber. We're still going to use the foam adhesive backing to actually attach this to the back of the motherboard tray. But I think with the rubber on top here, not only am I going to be able to slit this straight across, but then I'll be able to slit this into the corners, make like a V slit, then straight across another V slit. And that'll give this a little more, it'll relax a little bit better, make it a little bit easier to get your cables in and out. So anyway, you know, if you guys have seen the new Corsair case, that's where I got this idea from. So we're trying to implement that the best way we can. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm not going to bore you guys with, you know, the process of making these. So I'm going to go ahead and take off the old ones, and then I'll make the new ones with the rubber, and then we'll just see how it looks at the end. All right, here are the custom grommets made out of rubber. I'm actually pretty happy the way this turned out. We'll get in close and you can take a look there. But you see, as I was able to, you know, cut the little V slits in there, again, that's going to give it, you know, a little more play when you try to put your cables through. But anyway, I've noticed that the rubber is not as forgiving as the foam. So if you go ahead and do this and you use rubber, you're going to have to be very careful in cutting these to the exact size. You know, the foam, you know, if you're a little large, you can make it fit, but the rubber, you know, it'll just bow on you. All right, guys, I went ahead and reinstalled the motherboard. This way we can get a good look at what it looks like with the motherboard on there, and I went ahead and ran a couple of the cables. I ran about three or four SATA cables there, and the 24-pin. If we go all the way up here, we might be able to see where the 8-pin is. Right there. So that looks pretty good. You know, this revision to the mod of making custom grommets for your motherboard tray, I think this revision is really paid off. It was a little time consuming. Again, the rubber is a little more difficult to work with, but I'm pretty happy with the way it turned out. So if you guys, for the ones that haven't seen how to make these grommets, go ahead and watch an earlier video. It's called Making Custom Grommets for Your Motherboard Tray. And I walk you through exactly how to make these. So anyway, guys, I appreciate you viewing in. Thanks for all your support. You guys have a good day.